I do want to get to the sex scandal at Hewlett-Packard.
Mark Hurd took the helm of Hewlett-Packard 5 years ago. Under Hurd's leadership, the Silicon Valley company diversified to become the world's largest maker of personal computers, and the stock price nearly doubled.
A visionary, no question about it. A serious kind of nonsense guy, a businessman.
But last Friday, the married CEO was forced to resign following allegations that he falsified $20,000 in expenses to conceal a relationship with business associate Jody Fisher. From 2007 to 2009, HP paid Fisher as an event organizer. Fisher claims Hurd sexually harassed her. Although an internal investigation cleared him, Hurd settled with Fisher for an undisclosed amount.
That's unacceptable. It's bad PR. And the executive has to go.
I don't look my age, and most people would say I don't act it.
Fisher, a former actress, appeared in the reality show The Age of Love, competing with younger women for dates.
You're about to have fun.
She also played roles in steamy movies and hosted infomercials.
You can't get better than that.
Hurd is exiting with a payout estimated at $35 million. The market reacted violently. HP stock lost $9 billion in value on Monday. But analysts believe a rebound could be just around the corner.
The company is still strong. Wall Street saying the problem now, who's going to replace him?
That $40 million severance for Hurd shows just how highly valued he was for transforming HP. His departure also illustrates how complicated it is to fire a top executive without giving them that big payout, Erica.
Well, and I know there's more behind it, but if you're the average layperson looking at this, you think this guy has to leave in disgrace. He may have done a good job, but how is he able to still walk away with $40 million?
Well, Erica, right now, by the way, we should say that $40 million is the number a lot of experts are suggesting he could walk away with. But the reason that he could walk away with the money is because his contract, prior to this entire investigation, prior to these sexual harassment allegations, specifically states that he's going to walk away with a certain sum of money in the multi-million dollar range. And what happens in these cases with CEOs is they come into companies with contracts. The contract already tells them what they're going to make if they walk away, and there's very, very little that they can do aside from committing felony that
right.
will keep them from making the money.
Okay, so this isn't disgraceful enough, basically. It has to be really bad.
Yes.
On Sunday, former actress Jody Fisher named herself as the person who made the sexual harassment claim against former HP chairman and CEO Mark Hurd. He resigned from his position on Friday. Fisher said that she and Hurd first met in 2007 when she interviewed at HP. But that, quote, Mark and I never had an affair or intimate sexual relationship, end quote. She also said that she was, quote, surprised and saddened that Mark Hurd lost his job over this. That was never my intention, end quote. She said she has already resolved the sexual harassment claim privately with Hurd, without litigation, and does not intend to comment on it further. An investigation by HP found that Hurd had a personal relationship with her that he hid from the board and that he filed inaccurate expense reports meant to hide the relationship. It also revealed that there were numerous instances where Fisher was paid or reimbursed without having worked. HP could not immediately be reached for further comment. With reporting by Dan Nystedt, I'm Nick Barber, IDG News Service.